अ फ्यू क्विक टिप्स फॉर हेयर. Never use very warm water for washing your hair. Use lukewarm water as it will help open the cuticles of the hair so that the shampoo can penetrate deeper and remove the dirt and oil. Last rinse should be with cold water as it seals your cuticles, thus preventing damage. We all know untied hair is more prone to damage, but tying your hair too tight or too high can also cause a lot of damage. Therefore, tying your hair loosely or in a braid before sleeping can help prevent a lot of hair damage. People with long hair or bangs are more prone to forehead breakouts due to the oil and hair care products that they use. So always pull all of your hair off your face and clip your bangs back before you go to bed. Using shampoos directly on the scalp without diluting it in water can cause more damage to the hair. By diluting your shampoo, you can ensure it spreads evenly on your scalp and is rinsed easily. Do not rub your hair with towel to dry them, as it can lead to split ends. Instead, gently pat or blot dry your hair, and thereafter you can allow it to dry naturally. Hair is at its weakest when it is wet. Therefore, avoid combing your hair when it is wet, and instead comb them before shower or once they are half dry. I also recommend applying hair serums and using wide tooth combs for detangling your hair. Applying serums can prevent static or flyaway hair while combing. Patients with fine, thin or oily hair are often confused about the use of conditioners. I recommend them to use conditioners before shampooing. This reverse washing of your hair can help prevent product buildup and make your hair look flat and limp. Those with oily hair always tend to think they need extra strong shampoos to lift oil and dirt away from their scalp. But the fact is that using them will lead to stripping the scalp of the natural oils, which your scalp will replenish by overproduction. A tip for such patients is to use shampoos that are not too creamy or the ones that do not have a conditioner mixed in them. Another common myth about washing hair is that washing it more often will lead to more hair damage and hair fall. But the truth is that healthy hair are born by healthy scalp. So if you have an oily scalp that may attract dirt, or if you are staying in a polluted city, then washing your hair more often is beneficial. Here's an advice for all those who are using hair styling appliances and blow dryers often. Make sure you apply hair serums on cuticles of your hair to prevent them from getting damaged because of the heat. These days I get frequent queries on the use of essential oils and serums for the face. Since it's a very vast topic, we decided to discuss it in detail in our next blog. Hope this video was informative. For more updates, subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook and Instagram by clicking on the link below. Hi, I very often come across many common queries and myths on skin and hair care that my patients discuss with me. So we decided to pick this topic for today's video. Check our list of the most common skincare mistakes blocking your way to beautiful, clear and glowing skin. There's a lot of hype about regular use of peel-off mask, but peel-off mask can strip the skin of its natural oils, so avoid frequent use of peel-off mask. I get a lot of patient queries about their lips getting dark with time. A common mistake that such patients might be doing is using darker shades of lipsticks every day and retouching it multiple times in a day, which can lead to darkening of lips, as these lipsticks contain heavy metals like lead. If you're applying eye creams in a swiping motion on a daily basis, you could be unknowingly doing a great damage to your eyes and contributing to your dark circles. Instead of rubbing in your product, pat or dab them into the skin. The action of rubbing eyes too hard can even break blood vessels around your eyes and contribute to your dark circles. Excessive use of hand sanitizers or too frequently washing your hands with antiseptic soaps can strip off the essential oil and moisture from the skin and they can cause a lot of dryness. Therefore, switch to mild soaps and apply moisturizers every time after you wash your hands, at least in winters. Another common mistake that most of my patients do is choosing a face wash according to their skin problem and not according to their skin type. For instance, choosing a strong acne face wash for acne prone but dry skin will further strip off moisture from the skin and worsen the damage. So such patients can choose non-foaming, less drying cleansers and face washes. A very common query from my patients is which facial hair bleach is good for my skin. But the fact is that all bleaches contain chemicals like sodium hypochlorite, which is responsible for the bleaching action, and therefore all of them are the same. Here's a tip for those who are using waterproof mascaras frequently. Applying several coats of waterproof mascara is not good for your lashes. This is because the agents used to make it waterproof will also dry out on your lashes, and therefore it would take an extra effort to remove the waterproof mascara, leading to falling out of your lashes. Excessive and prolonged use of nail paints can lead to yellowing of nails due to chemical reaction between the color and the nail plate. So avoid wearing nail paints regularly and keep your nails bare at least one day in a week. I quite often hear this from my patients that sunscreen is not required in winters or cloudy days, while the fact is that fluorescent bulbs at home can also cause a lot of photo damage, and studies have shown that sitting all day in front of your laptops is equivalent to 20 minutes of sunbathing. Therefore, sunscreens must be worn 365 days of the year, whether you are inside or outside the house. Here's a quick tip for those who are shaving their legs regularly. Hair conditioners contain moisturizing properties and can hydrate your skin if applied instead of shaving creams before shaving. They are great for sensitive skin and ensure your razor glides smoothly to avoid nasty cuts. Studies have shown that your mobile handsets may have 18 times more harmful germs on it than the flush handle. So keep your mobile screens clean to avoid pimples or sweat rashes. Persistently pressing your face on cotton pillowcases while sleeping can increase collagen breakdown due to friction. To minimize this, you can switch to silk pillowcases. Hope this video was informative. For more updates, subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook and Instagram by clicking on the link below.